जैसे दिग्विजय जस्ट आस्क्ड मी व्हाट रोल्स डज द गुरु प्ले. सो हियर आई सॉ इन द पूजा गुरुदेव वॉज गुरुदेव. द मोमेंट द पूजा गॉट ओवर द वे ही टोल्ड अस हैव फूड हैव प्रसाद एंड ही हैड बिकम अ होस्ट ऑफ द हाउस एंड वी वेर द गेस्ट. सो ही वॉज जस्ट प्लेइंग द रोल ऑफ द होस्ट एंड नॉट जस्ट टेलिंग अस टू ईट. ही केम अप ऑन द टेरेस. ही हैड नॉट ईटन. ही एंश्योर्ड दैट एवरीबडी इज ईटिंग प्रॉपरली. यू नो दे आर गेटिंग वॉट दे वॉन्ट. सो एवरी रोल द मास्टर प्लेज टू परफेक्शन एंड देर आर सो मेनी रोल्स. सो इट्स ऑन एंड ऑन.
देर आर सो मेनी रोल्स एंड वी आर लकी टू सी हिम इन डिफरेंट रोल्स ऑल्सो. एनी एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर दैट. वॉट डिफरेंट रोल्स.
Once I was in Belgium as part of my work. I had a temporary visa. It was actually a tourist visa. It was getting converted into a work visa, but it would require some 15 days. And within 7 days, on the weekend, Gurudev was scheduled to come to Holland. It was a 2-day retreat program with Gurudev for people. Mainly from Europe. So I said, this is a great opportunity because I'll be here another 3-4 months. I won't get to see him. This is the best chance. But then when I found out, I was told that you are on a temporary permit. On this permit, you cannot cross the Belgian border. You cannot go to another country. You can do that once your temporary permit becomes a permanent permit or whatever it is. So I thought and I said, let me just leave it to the grace. If Gurudev wants me to come there, if he wants to take care of this, he will handle it. So I boarded the train. I went to some corporation office there and they told me that in the train, if they do some inspection or checking, they might not allow you. They might ask you to deboard the train. I said, okay, let me take the risk. So I went. About 15 minutes before we were to cross the Belgium-Holland border, a few officials, one or two officials came and they started checking everybody's identity cards and tickets. I thought, okay, it looks like now I have to get off the train. The guard, they were not checking everybody. Randomly, they would pick up somebody. So they picked up the person sitting, on my left, and they picked up somebody sitting in the next, section. But they didn't pick me up. We crossed the border. I got off at Holland. 2 days, I attended the program with Gurudev. And there were very few people. So for a person, from India, आप कहीं भी जाओ, किसी भी आश्रम जाओ, बैंगलोर आश्रम जाओ, गुजरात आश्रम जाओ, ऋषिकेश आश्रम जाओ, आपको भीड़ मिलेगी गुरुदेव के आसपास. वहाँ पे कुछ 60-70 लोग थे और फिर शाम को सत्संग के बाद फिर गुरुदेव के साथ आराम से 1-2 घंटे बैठने का मौका मिलता था, छोटे छोटे ग्रुप्स में. फिर गुरुदेव कुछ लोगों को मिल रहे थे. इतना डाउन टू अर्थ, मतलब एक मेरे लिए एक अलग ही रूप था वो गुरुदेव का. बहुत ज्यादा एक्सेसिबल थे गुरुदेव एंड ही वॉज वेरी वेरी कैजुअल देयर. तो नाउ सी हाउ गुरुदेव ही टेक्स अ लिटिल, ही ट्रीट्स यू आई वाज डिस्कसिंग डिफरेंट रोल्स ही प्लेस. At one point of time, I remember in the evening, somebody from Holland Press, Holland TV was going to come to interview him. And I was sitting in the room with Gurudev. There was just one or two other people. They also left. So it's just me and Gurudev. And Gurudev said, okay, so let me get ready for the interview. So he went to the washroom, he came out and he said, so now, am I looking ready for the interview? So, for me it was like, who am I to judge whether you are ready for the interview? you are Gurudev, so you know best. So, but I said, yeah, Gurudev, nice, but just a little creases, you know, on your kurta. Oh, is it? So he said, okay, let me change. I never thought he will take this so seriously. Gurudev actually went and he changed and he came, okay. So now is it fine? I said, yes. Here again I saw him in, you know, in a different role. He, just like a friend asks another friend, kya lag raha hai? Main ready ho kya? Change karo. It was like that. I actually asked Gurudev, how come you are so simple? Gurudev said, that is how I am. Then, okay, interview happened. That evening passed. And then in the night, I was supposed to board my train back because it was Sunday night. Monday, I have to go to office. Now, again, I saw him in another role. So, it was quite late. I had a train at around 10 p.m. It was 9:30 or something. There was another train at 11. At around 9:30, I should have got up and gone to the railway station. But I thought, let me spend one more hour. I'll take the 11 p.m. train. At around 10:15, there was a group of a family who were going to leave by car to Belgium. So, Gurudev asked me, Acha, how are you going to go? I said, I have 11 p.m. train. Gurudev said, they are going by car, why don't you go with them? They can drop you somewhere close by. They are also going to Belgium. So I didn't want to go actually. I just wanted that extra 45 minutes with Gurudev. I said, Gurudev, it's fine. I mean, why to trouble them? I have 11 p.m. train. Again, Gurudev said, but see, you can go with them. You can go in the car if you want. You can join them. See, when Gurudev is indicating, Gurudev doesn't, many times he doesn't impose anything on you. He doesn't tell you, do this. He says, how about, that actually is an indication that that is the best option. And that is the right option to do. This I have realized after many incidents. I said, but because Gurudev was giving me the option, I thought, okay, let me not take the option. I said, no, I'll take the 11 p.m. train. Again, I repeated the same thing. Again, he just said, but dekho, jana hai to, unke saath ja sakte. Third time he said. I had to get up. That was the last train. Monday morning I have to be in office. And I went. Now this rarely happens in Europe. The train did not come. The train had got cancelled for some reason. Now the station master, he came and apologized to me. I was... really, I admire this customer sensitivity, which I saw there. He came and apologized to me. He said, there is another train which has left, which will be halting at the next station. And if you want, I will book a cab for you. And the cab will reach faster till the next station. And you can board the train, the other train, from the next station. And you can still go to your destination. Now what thought is going on in my mind? Now see again, this is a divine hand that is actually working for me. But what is going on in my mind? My mind is having the craving that now this is a good chance. I can go back and spend one more night. I can still go and spend some more time with Gurudev till as long as he goes to sleep. Tomorrow morning again I can see him and I can go by a morning train. So the station master is telling me, I can arrange for a cab. You don't have to pay anything. We are very sorry. The train has not come. This rarely happens. But you are one of the passengers. You have a ticket. So we will reach you till the next station. And we will ensure that you get to board the other train which will reach you. I said, no. You don't need to take that trouble. I'm fine. So I'll go tomorrow morning. So I did not take that offer. I went back. And at around 11:30, I am back in Gurudev's room. And Gurudev looks at me. Kya? Gurudev says, अरे यार ये वापस आ गया. तो गुरुदेव वो ट्रेन ही कैंसिल हो गया. फिर अभी मैं बोला फिर अभी तो अभी फिर यही रुक जाता हूँ. So Gurudev, there was Philip Fraser, you know, the advanced course teacher who plays the flute. All of you must have heard his flute music during meditation. So he said, okay, then Philip, you give him some place to sleep in your room. Then I think he'll leave tomorrow morning. I said, ha, tomorrow. So then Gurudev is asking me, now again, you know, this I saw him like a parent. He said, फिर ऑफिस में इन्फॉर्म किया कि कल लेट हो जाएगा आने में, तो कल कितने बजे पहुंचोगे, व्हाट टाइम यू विल लीव टुमारो मॉर्निंग. व्हाट टाइम ऑफिस स्टार्ट्स, आई सेड 8 o'clock. सो यू विल नॉट रीच एट 8 o'clock टू ऑफिस, आई सेड नो, आई थिंक आई विल रीच बाय 11 ओनली. सो देन यू विल हैव टू इन्फॉर्म देम राइट दैट यू आर गेटिंग लेट टुमारो. आई थॉट व्हाई इज गुरुजी यू नो गेटिंग इनटू दीस स्मॉल नीटिग्रिटीज एज ही इज माय मदर और ही इज माय फादर. बट देन ही एंश्योर्ड एंड ही टोल्ड मी, सो यू प्लीज इन्फॉर्म know them and you tell them that you will be reaching a little late. So I don't know, there are so many different roles. Suddenly he is a friend, suddenly he is a parent, suddenly you know he is a host, suddenly he is a guru. So
definitely Gurudev dekhte hain that hum sari responsibility theek se kar rahe hain, and he is there to ensure that we are living our life fully with full responsibility, and also we get to spend time with him and have a lot of fun. He is ultimate mentor, don't you?
Absolutely.
Any other similar experience would you like?
Yeah, as a mentor, I mean, Gurudev is, his mentoring is of a completely different dimension. I mean, I don't think there is anybody on this planet who can mentor like this. Who, a mentor who doesn't even make you feel that he is mentoring you. And that is the beauty. Pata nahi chalta कि वो आपको एक्चुअली ट्रेन कर रहे हैं, ग्रूम कर रहे हैं, मोल्ड कर रहे हैं, पता नहीं चलता. दैट इज द सटल, यू नो, सो सटल, इतने सूक्ष्म तरीके से वो करते हैं. तो जैसे मुझे याद है कि हमने एक बहुत बड़ा दिल्ली में प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइज किया था जब गुरुदेव भी आए थे. ब्रह्मनाद इवेंट हुआ था जिसमें बहुत सारे आई थिंक सितार वादक 1100 या 1200 सितार वादक ने परफॉर्म किया था स्टेज पे एक साथ. एंड उसके साथ साथ देर वॉज अ यूथ प्रोग्राम उत्सव, एस प्लस प्रोग्राम. तो अबाउट 4650 पीपल, यू नो, अतिका जी एंड माई सेल्फ, वी वेर प्राइमरीली इन चार्ज ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दैट इवेंट. एंड इट वॉज अ बिग थिंग फॉर टू मंथ्स ऑलमोस्ट वी वेर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दैट. वो प्रोग्राम हो गया, स्पेशली आई हैड गॉन टू दिल्ली फॉर दैट पर्पज. वो प्रोग्राम हो गया, फिर हम वापस आ गए. एंड देन आई गॉट एन इंस्ट्रक्शन फ्रॉम गुरुदेव, दिल्ली जाओ, दिल्ली जाओ, नो अदर कॉन्वर्सेशन. वहां जाके करना क्या है, कितना टाइम रहना है, किस रीजन में रहना है. अच्छा, आर्ट ऑफ लिविंग के इतने सारे कार्य चलते हैं, कहां मुझे फोकस करना है. नो अदर इंस्ट्रक्शन, job. So I just went, and I went, I did not even know where I'm going to stay. Somehow things started getting arranged, different devotees' houses. Then there was some house where nobody used to stay, it was owned by a devotee. They said, okay, you live here, other volunteers also can, you know, be here, etc., etc. It took me quite some time to figure out ki karna kya hai. But then I realized, now see, this is, you know, a mentoring of a very high level where Gurudev gave me an instruction, go to Delhi. I had to find out what I'm supposed to do there. What is my role there? So for that, what happens? A churning happens within me. I keep thinking, I keep experimenting. I realize, okay, this is not what I'm supposed to do. No, this is not what I'm supposed to do. And finally, when I figure out, okay, this is what I'm supposed to do. But this whole process has taught me so much. In this whole process, I have done so many failed experiments. And these failed experiments have taught me so much. It was very easy for him to tell me, go to Delhi, be here, focus on these activities, and this is what I want you to, you know, get done by this time. No timeline, no targets, you know. Where, which boss you will find who will not give you a timeline, who will not give you any targets, who will not tell you exactly in, you know, what line of operation you have to be in. Nothing is told. This is the kind of mentoring. And then the same thing repeats. After about spending 4 years in Delhi, we were at some airport seeing him off. I think it was Aurangabad airport. In fact, Digvijay was there at that time. Because Digvijay was one of the volunteers we had organized, again a similar youth big program, and Gurudev had addressed on the last day. Then where we went to see off Gurudev, a very important thing, you know, Gurudev mentioned at that time. Again, see how the a great mentor is, you know, he is ahead of you. He knows where to catch you. He can sense where you are going wrong, and even before you can say it, you know, he somehow gets it out from you, you know. So he asked me one question, how are your courses going on? I said, good, Gurudev. Just before that Aurangabad event, we were in Delhi. We had organized the March Against Corruption. The March Against Corruption, which was, we worked 3 months, the whole Delhi team worked, the youth team of Delhi worked 3 months for that program. It was a march against corruption where we gathered 10,000 youngsters on Parliament Street. These 10,000 youngsters were from different universities, colleges across Delhi. And Gurudev was not there in this event, but he had told us to organize this. And social leaders were invited for this event. It was only after this event, this march against corruption. In fact, we had invited the current Chief Minister of New Delhi, Arvind Kejriwal, for that event. He was an upcoming social activist at that time. So one of the speeches, one of the talks was by him at that time. At that time there was no political party which he had started. And after this, that movement against corruption started, it picked up, and then India Against Corruption was formed, etc., etc. That's another subject altogether. But this is how it had started. So, ye event organized karte vakt, you know, the whole day we used to be visiting different institutes, colleges, so I had not taught any Art of Living course for 2 to 3 months. Because the whole focus was this event. So, at Aurangabad airport, 1 week after this event, they asked me, how are your courses going on? So I said, going good. He said, are you teaching everything? He asked me. He's never asked me this. Now he asked me, are you teaching every week? So I said, not every week, Gurudev. Not last 2 months, because we were organizing the event, March Against Corruption in Delhi. So Gurudev, you know, said, I've never seen him give such an expression, you know. कोर्स से इवेंट होता है, इवेंट से कोर्स नहीं. कभी भी कोर्सेस पे कॉम्प्रोमाइज मत किया करो. आई हैव यू नो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर्ड दीज टू लाइन्स इन माय लाइफ. कोर्स से इवेंट होता है, दिस इज अ रियली वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग यू नो इनपुट एजुकेशन गाइडलाइन फॉर ऑल आर्ट ऑफ लिविंग वॉलंटियर्स एंड टीचर्स. एज यू टीच कोर्सेस, इवेंट्स गेट, you know, events are a manifestation. They get created, generated out of the course. From the event course, this rarely happens. So course is the engine. On that, you can organize whatever you want. So, kabhi courses pe compromise. And then he said, abhi Maharashtra pe focus karo. So, you know, I was all set to go back to Delhi, and because already now we had organized the March Against Corruption, Meri Delhi, Meri Yamuna, another great social project which we organized there. When I had gone to Delhi, there were just two youth Art of Living teachers there. In these 3 years, now they were about 40 plus. So, you know, all this activity had happened. And I was the level of mentoring which human beings cannot do. I had thought, see, I spent 3 years in Delhi, and from 2, the youth teachers team has grown to 40 plus. From 50 to 60 volunteers, the volunteer team is now 700 to 1,000 volunteers. and I had my dreams, you know, so now this is how I should, now the foundation is done, now I should develop like this, like that. Ye sab karna chahiye. There was, that ego was there, the doership was there. And in like, in one sentence, Gurudev had just smashed everything. He told me this, you know, event se course nahi, course se event hota hai, kabhi courses pe compromise mat karo. And he said, abhi Maharashtra pe focus karo. So all, you know, I could, in that one second, I could see all my Delhi plans just crumbling like a pack of cards. And suddenly, I know I have to go to a different state. I had not been in Maharashtra for about 3 to 4 years. You know, just would go once in a while. Now, abhi Maharashtra pe focus karo. Again, no other indication, no other explanation. Maharashtra is such a big state. So many cities in Maharashtra. What to do, where to go in Maharashtra? Bombay, Pune, Nagpur, Nasik, Jalgaon, you know, Vidarbh, where? No instruction. But then I created Maharashtra. So this is how it is, you know, how sensitive, knowing what is going on at the level of your spirit. You know, it is not even a mind training. It is not a task-oriented training. See, for us, we take up different projects, which are different tasks. Gurudev's project is you. His project is you. He is working on you. You as a person, not even as a personality. It is not a mind management training that Gurudev is mentoring you in. He is, you know, removing those cobwebs which are not even visible, where you are stuck here and there, which could be an inhibition in your spiritual journey. He is removing those obstacles in a very fine manner, in a very subtle way, and sometimes with very strong, harsh blows. And he is ensuring that your spiritual journey keeps going on. The mind becoming stronger, the blossoming of your personality, these are the side effects. This automatically happens. On this path, as you are progressing and as the master is, you know, holding you, sometimes he is pushing you from behind, sometimes he is pulling you from where you are stuck, sometimes before you reach somewhere, he has already removed the obstacle, you know, and cleared the path for you. Sometimes he is just patiently waiting. You know, come on, when are you going to tread this? Come. He is patiently waiting. So, that's another great aspect, you know, of Gurudev. Patience, infinite patience. I think he can wait lifetimes. You know, he can even wait till his next incarnation for you to really come to the other shore. Because I remember my first few times, I had opportunities to meet Gurudev, but I never even went to meet him. The first satsang, Maha Satsang, which I attended, I did not even take any effort that I should go and meet him. You know, somebody came and told, Gurudev is now going to this house. Would you like to come there? Maybe you can see Gurudev from a close distance. Say, so, it's okay, satsang is done, I'm fine. You know, another Mahasatsang happened. Gurudev was in Bandra Reclamation Grounds, and surprisingly few people were there in that satsang, only about 3,000 to 4,000, because the ground was big and preparations were such that he could have accommodated 25,000 to 30,000 people. So at the end of the satsang, Gurudev said that, okay, you know, all of you can, you know, queue up and you can come on stage one by one. I will meet each and every one of you. So, I thought, what is the need? Why should I go on stage and meet you? I heard what you said. You spoke very nice words. Nice. I did the meditation you guided us into. Nice. We had bhajans, you know, and it was nice, you know, in your presence. We aage aake milne ki kya zarurat hai. People started, the moment this announcement Gurudev did, people just started queuing up one after the other. And 2,500 to 3,000 people were in that queue. I was sitting somewhere in the ground. Rashmin joined the queue immediately. He said, main jaake milke aane wala hu. I told him, okay, then I'll wait for you. I don't want to go and meet him. I'll wait for you, then we'll go back home together. So I just kept sitting. I went to the Divine Shop. I purchased a few audio cassettes. one or two books. I was looking at the exhibition of Art of Living Seva projects, you know, education for poor children, etc., etc. And I was just trying to kill time. And I'm seeing Gurudev is meeting each and every one, and everybody is really coming back so gratified, so fulfilled. You know, some are just into bliss after having met him. Still, you know, this thought is not coming to my mind that I should go and meet. Then what happened? My first Art of Living teacher, Dinesh Nair, he came, you know, walking around there, and he said, "Salil, did you go and hug Gurudev?" I said, "No." "Then go in the line, you know, see he's hugging, you can go and hug him, go in the line." So I went, I said, my Art of Living teacher is saying I should listen to my Art of Living teacher. So I went and stood in the line for about 5 minutes. And then I thought, still, I think there are almost 1,500 people ahead of me. It will take another 1 hour. I said, forget it, you know. Again, I came back out of the queue. I just sat on the chair. I just waited for Rashmin to finish his turn. You know, when Rashmin hugged Gurudev, you know, they both laughed. They both laughed loudly. I don't know why. Rashmin also doesn't know why. And Rashmin came back, and then we went back home. So, what I'm telling you is that maybe, you know, Gurudev has waited. You know, इसको कब अकल आएगी, कभी इसकी ग्रंथियां खुलेगी, कभी इसको चमकेगा कि कौन है भाई, क्या हो रहा है तुम्हारे लाइफ में, और तुम क्यों मतलब वहीं पड़े हो. यू नो, यहां पे मैं तुमको एक बता रहा हूं रास्ता, तुम क्यों रुके हो. बिकॉज आई रिमेंबर आफ्टर दिस व्हेन आई वेंट टू द आश्रम, नाउ आई वॉन्टेड टू मीट हिम टू द बैंगलोर आश्रम. He was meeting a few people at the reception, near the reception somewhere. It was not like a proper darshan, but some people were there. And I had just reached with my bags also. I just kept the bags at the side when I came to know that Gurudev is there outside already. It was evening, so I went there. And as he was meeting a few people, he noticed I have come. So he just looked at me and he said, "Aa gaye." That "aa gaye" was very profound, because you know, finally it was the calling from within that had brought me there. Now I had actually come out of a longing, my heart was telling that go and have some moments with Gurudev. So that agai was okay. So finally now you have reached. You know, two Mahasatsangs in Bombay, and then, you know, one or two other opportunities to meet, and still that had not happened. So he said, agai. It was like, I've been waiting like more than 2 years now. Or I don't know what, I don't know, lifetimes. Now you have come. So that's the patience that a master has. And There is no judgment, there is no evaluation, there is no condition. Why should he be waiting for me? What have I done for the Guru? But the Guru is waiting for you so that he can do something for you. See, if you compare this to a relationship, suppose you make a new friend, you know, there are so many expectations that you have from a new friend, and as you become more and more close, the expectations start building up. Even in a relationship, you are in love with someone. Behind the love, there is an expectation. There are so many conditions that your love should be reciprocated in a certain manner. But here, there is a person who, in spite of zero reciprocation from the other side, is only wanting to give you more and more. So, this is unconditional love. This is unconditional acceptance. This only a guru can be like that. Even a parent cannot be like that. Husband and wife, definitely not. Boyfriend, girlfriend, friends. It's something very different. Our intellect cannot comprehend this. Right? This. these are matters beyond our logic. And Gurudev, you know, takes every opportunity to thrash your logic. Your concepts get thrashed. Suddenly he might, you know, throw something at you. He might throw you in a situation where you thought, I mean, how could this be? Right? So I'll give you one example. This was a satsang. One young boy stood up and he asked, Gurudev, I'm in this satsang for the first time. I've come first time to this ashram. I don't know you. Why should I trust you? Can you please give me some reason why I should have faith in you? So Gurudev, you know, Gurudev gave him like a very stylish, you know, naughty look. Oh, so you want me to convince you that you should trust me? No way. My job is to confuse you. I'm not going to convince you. You find out. That's your job. My job is to put the doubt. This was a very new thing for me. That master's job is to put the doubt. It is the disciple's, the devotee's job to transcend the doubt. Not the master's job. Just imagine, the guru is putting doubt in your mind about the guru. And he will do everything to encourage that. Where does this happen? You know? Another incident. This is again about, you know, any management coach or any motivational coach, the way they coach people, you know, it's up to, you know, one level, one dimension. Gurudev's, you know, it goes beyond. So he really breaks so many concepts. So a guy asked, Gurudev, I want to improve my confidence. What should I do? So now I was really waiting for this answer. What is Gurudev going to say now? Because there are, as an art of living teacher, so many people come to me saying, I want to improve my confidence. What should I do? And typically, when we want to boost somebody's confidence, what do? We encourage them, we praise them. You know, when they succeed in small things, we tell them, see, very good, you've done so well. I'm sure you can do much better. Keep it up. This is how we boost someone, we encourage someone. You know what Gurudev's answer was? How to improve confidence? Gurudev said, make mistakes. That's it, two words. Make mistakes. And I have realized in life that actually my confidence has grown by making mistakes. When I gave myself the permission to make mistakes. So this was another big concept breaker for me. That about the knowledge that how does actually confidence come, and about training someone, how to train someone. You know, it is not just as a trainer, you are not just someone who is supposed to be goody-goody and, oh yeah, well done, very nice. No. You let that person get humiliated also. You let that person fall. Rising up after you have fallen down is success. And when Gurudev said in another instance, that just like success pulls you ahead in life, failures don't take you behind. Failures push you ahead. My concept of failure changed when I heard this. We have heard the proverb, failure is a stepping stone to success, you know. But what happens ultimately? When you fail, you get so dejected, you get so demotivated. But when Gurudev said, just like success pulls you ahead in life, failure pushes you ahead in life. Failure is something which pushes you ahead in life. Again, a big concept breaker for me. So the master is here to break all the concepts. Only when you go beyond the concepts, then the real truths of life start opening up for you. And Gurudev does it in a very nice way.
Success, as you rightly said, success pulls you ahead and failure pushes you ahead. But maybe not in the direction you want, but maybe in some better direction.
Yeah, correct.
What very Gurudev cool. has in store for you.
Yeah.
So you mentioned that you were you were not very keen going and meeting Gurudev on the stage. So how this transition from non-believer to believer happened?
That is where, you know, I see Gurudev has kept so much patience for that transition from non-believer to believer. Because since I had done the first Art of Link program, since I learned Sudarshan Kriya, I think for this transition to happen, it took about 2 to 2.5 years. And I had so many opportunities to meet Gurudev in that period. So again, as I was talking earlier, because this question connects to another, how Gurudev, you know, becomes a mother for you. So what happened is about in 97, the end of 97, November 1997, I did the Art of Link program for the first time. And I used to do Sudarshan Kriya regularly. I used to not like that my Art of Living teacher, when Dinesh Nair, when he used to come to the course, he used to first, you know, fold his hands and go down his head to Gurudev's photograph. Then he would keep a flower at Gurudev's photograph, and then he would start teaching the course. Me being from completely a left-oriented thinking background and information technology, software programming background, I was totally logic-driven. For me, this made no sense, you know, you are just going down to somebody. I used to never even say Jai Gurudev. I used to find it very old-fashioned. I would, you know, my teacher would say Jai Gurudev, I would say good morning, good evening, you know, hello, hi, how are you? I used to find Jai Gurudev very old-fashioned and, you know, like a backward thing. When my mother got cancer, and then the cancer started spreading very fast, and that time, as the cancer was spreading fast, Gurudev visited Bombay. In the house, you know, we discussed, should we go and ask Gurudev what to do about my mother? She was becoming very weak. Whether she can even do Sudarshan Kriya. She had done the course, but she was not practicing Sudarshan Kriya. So, Rashmin said, let's go and ask Gurudev what to do.